Hello, everybody. Welcome to Acadia. Yes, this is apparently where the synths live, although none of them come out to meet me. I've got a new friend called Old Longfellow, and me and Old Boy are going to go up here. People have told me to go back and get Nick Valentine, but I figure you've probably seen enough people get the old Nicky Poo in this situation. And I'm just going to go up and have a good old chinwag to the people that live in Acadia. I'm going to call it... 20 a day, I'm guessing. I mean, of course there is like radioactive smog, so you know, probably not a thing. Oh, I can just take that. That's fine. I'm okay with just taking shit. So yes, we're gonna go in and speak to him, and we're not gonna bring Nick, even though I know this is a synth colony and Nick's probably got like everything to say. Oh, we've got some nice things, but there are no people about. This is a good colony of synths that have no one here. I must remember, I'm playing as a synth sympathizer. Okay, who might you be?
When I first climbed this mountain above the fog, I thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in. You've entered a place of clarity, understanding. Peace.
Okay.
While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
I have no beef with synths, you know, sarcasm.
Well, in that case, I want a Nuka-Cola, some stim packs, Kasumi Nakano returned to her family, and, a pony.
I see. I'm afraid some of those things I'm not in a position to give. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, do you think Kasumi is a synth?
Oh, you betcha. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
She's a synth. That's why she left home.
Kasumi had honest questions about herself. She came here for answers.
Okay.
None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie.
Lucky her.
That someone stripped her very identity from her and made her into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect...
Oh, are you suggesting I'm a synth? I'm pretty sure that I might be a synth.
Tell me, are you a synth?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
I have to be honest. In the back of my mind, I've always suspected.
That's what I thought. If you don't mind, what's the first thing you can remember?
That's an interesting question. I guess the day the bombs fell, really, because literally that's all I can remember. Because in this game, you start in the game, and I have no memory of my childhood. Day the bombs fell.
I remember being in my house the day the bombs fell. We ran to the vault. We were frozen. I was the only survivor.
No memories before then? Just a single day? And then waking up alone? We so easily accept what's presented to us as the truth, don't we? Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality?
Mm-hmm.
People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind.
But I've always assumed that she was a synth anyway.
We can accept you, no matter what you decide you are.
Yeah, where's Kasumi? Well, whatever.
Dude, spare me the lecture.
Fine. But Acadia is still open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders, Faraday and Chase. Kasumi is usually working down below, whenever you wish to see her. Did you need anything else before?
Yeah,
you go?
What are you? Give me a second. Okay, I should probably mention that I'm in the railroad.
I'm part of a group that helps synths. A railroad.
Really? I don't understand why a group dedicated to helping synths would convince them through fear that their only option is to hide.
Because if they don't
hide, they volunteer for the memory wipe. Yes, not knowing you're a synth makes it harder for the Institute to find you. But the cost, I know how frightening it is, the risk of capture. But sacrificing what you are, avoiding the true struggle to be accepted as our own form of life?
Here's the thing. The railroad genuinely wipes the memories of living things to protect them. That's like me going, I'm me.
All right.
Yeah, I'm having a seizure. I'm me. Oh, I'm a synth. Now wipe everything about me. That's basically what you're asking people to do. You've taken them at a crucial time of their life and then wiped their memories. Personally, wiping your memory is the last thing you want to do. I'm
take your time.
Shut up. I'm not here to debate.
I didn't come to argue. I just wanted you to know we're out there, helping your people.
I know. I'm sorry. It's easy for me to worry about our ideals while I'm so far away from the Commonwealth, in relative safety. Can I help you with anything else?
No, I'm no, nothing else. You're all synths. I doubt they're all synths.
We're in there a long time. Are you feeling all right?
I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we blew 3 more relays this week. I'm coming in. You stay right there.
Help the synths of Arcadia. Arcadia. Where did you get that? Did you just steal that cup? Why are you bringing a glass on the road, bro? Who's this guy that's just coming in? I'm supposed to help people. You. There you are. Hello.
So, you've talked to Dima. You know why we're here. I certainly hope that you'll consider helping us. Dima's vision is worth fighting for.
Synths deserve safety.
You're right. It is a good cause. Synths definitely deserve to be safe, just like everyone else.
It's so good to hear that. Very encouraging. Please, make sure Dima knows that as well. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy devoted to helping others. He never stops to think of himself.
And that's where Dima, I think, is the bad guy.
Well, if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Sarcasm.
Right. Wouldn't want him blowing a fuse, huh?
No, not really.
Right, tell me about his organs.
Looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly
he's gone under the knife a few times, is what
Between
I'm saying.
Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. He was just a prototype, never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so much. He's become so much more than he once was. And all he thinks of is others.
I don't think he does, because this is Fallout. People who are kind to others very rarely have good intentions. Okay, so tell me about
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. It's likely somewhat dangerous, though, so I understand if you'd rather not.
I laugh in the face of danger.
It was transporting some hardware we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still out there. I could really use them here for extra parts, if nothing else. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So, does this sound like something
you
could handle?
If you ask me to my face, that would be great. Can you tell me what happened?
What happened to the boat? Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. And what might still be out there. The point is that we already lost
Myla
someone
Queen.
Once. I don't want to see that happen again. So, are you up for it?
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah, got it covered.
Sure thing, Faraday. I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it.
Okay, so... they made him sinister, which makes me think he might actually be a good guy. I'm really not convinced. Really, really. There's someone else back here.
You track Kasumi here. I'm impressed.
Who are you?
Perhaps not as quietly or efficiently as possible. But thankfully, she was never in any real danger.
Are you next?
Your journey are you a courser?
Sarcasm.
Miss out on a fun boat ride? Never.
Well, then at least you have the return trip to look forward to. Acadia is a safe haven for synths. Were it not, I would not have aided anyone in reaching it. Every synth I've tracked down, every synth convinced to come here, has been assured that he or she will come to no harm. My job is to make sure they all remain safe, no matter what. Understand?
Yeah, I've taken out courses. How do you find them?
How do you manage to track down synths and bring them here?
That's not a subject we need to discuss.
Oh, okay.
I manage. That's all that matters. You have Dima's blessing. So by all means, make yourself comfortable.
Okay, well I want to help. What's your story? Yeah, you're
so,
obviously
what's
a...
your story?
I used to be a courser.
Of course you did. The outfit
that
gave
I
it away.
From the Institute. I was tracking a synth and instead found Dima. He convinced me of the truth and the error of my ways. I rejected the Institute, made sure they couldn't track me, and dedicated my life to instead helping synths find freedom.
That's a noble cause. Okay. Tell me how
I'd
to
like
help.
To help you all. Is there anything I can do?
Actually, as a matter of fact, there is. If you're serious about contributing, well, we've got a situation I need someone to look into. You've had some experience traveling around the island. So you may be
not really.
To handle it.
I'm listening.
All right, I'm listening.
We were expecting a new synth to arrive, and he should have been here by now. There's been no sign of him, and I'm concerned that he might have become lost on the way here.
Ah. Sarcasm.
This island is a death trap. Your synth probably ended up as Mirelurk food.
I certainly hope not, but I'd like to know for certain. You should start by talking to Brooks in Far Harbor. He's one of us.
Oh!
A synth.
Do they
he's
know?
He's the one who meets the new arrivals and gets them started on the journey here. Of course, he's not likely to tell you anything without proof that you're working for me. If he doesn't cooperate, tell him that his designation is L792. That should convince him. That's as much help as
that's
I can
quite interesting. There's a Please, synth in hurry. Far Harbor.
If that synth is out there alone, he won't last long.
No, I'm a good guy. I'm a good guy. I'm not with the Brotherhood. I don't want to murder all the filthy synths. The filthy, filthy synths. Someone down here? Oh, lots of people. There's like tons of people around this area.
So, I understand you've seen a good bit of our island. What do you think?
Oh, it's a hellhole.
Quaint. It's sort of an old world, burn it to the ground and salt the earth kind of charm.
Interesting. Of course, it was already burned to the ground once. I'm not sure attempting that again would yield much. This island, with all of its danger and beauty, predates you and I. The ecosystem isn't what it once was, but it has adapted, and it will continue to adapt, long after we're gone. What's important, really important in the long run, is understanding
it. I doubt
that. And then passing that knowledge along to those who will follow us.
Ooh, more sarcasm.
That's what floats your boat?
It gives me a sense of purpose, yes. I like having something worthwhile to which I can dedicate my time. I should note that I'm not fully versed in human anatomy. But I'm your best chance of medical assistance should you require
it. Is that a threat?
Since Dima has approved of you, I'm more than willing to offer help.
You got really glassy eyes. Oh, doctor.
I could use a doctor.
Well, I'm the closest you're going to get around here.
Rad scrub.
What do you need a doctor for?
All the rads. Cure me.
Not feeling great at the moment.
What ails you?
Like so many rads?
Too much radiation. I feel sick.
Okay. You're not going to like this, but it'll be worth it.
Said the worst thing ever. Ew, she poked me with a pointy thing.
Was there anything else?
No.
Never mind. We're done.
Thanks for the practice, I guess. Try and stay safe out there.
That's just what you want your doctor to say. Ah, thanks for the practice. Oh, God.
Sounds like you got the all clear.
Cog.
So what's your story?
Kasumi.
I came here looking for Kasumi.
Oh, isn't that sweet of you? That Kasumi's a good enough kid, I suppose. A little confused, maybe. But then, aren't we all? Not that anyone's asking, but I'll tell you. It all gets easier to deal with when you realize none of it matters. What you are, where you came from, let go of all that, and life gets simple.
You don't care?
Is there anything you care about?
I mean, staying alive is preferable to not. Beyond that, what's the point of caring? Anyway, lately I've taken to amusing myself with trading. Don't have much to work with, but I'm always happy to make a good deal. Let me know if you need something. I probably won't have it, but let me know anyway.
Okay, well, yeah, I'm going to barter with you. Let's see what you've got.
Let's do some business.
Nothing particularly cool, but this is quite nice. But it's a bit rich for my tastes, to be honest. So I'm just going to sell off some stuff.
I assume you're not planning on staying long.
Was that a problem?
After a welcome this warm, who wouldn't want to just stay forever?
This place isn't for you. Acadia is only as secure as we make it. We take unnecessary risks. We get careless, and things can go bad. Fast. If there's a synth who needs a safe place, then we take them in. Let them live as a synth, without fear. You don't fit that description.
Which bit?
It makes you an unnecessary risk. It's nothing personal. Minimizing our contact with outsiders is just practical.
You must have tons of friends with this attitude.
I don't need friends.
Yeah, you're a bit... Hello. I will take your free ammo that you have just decided to leave.
Did you need something?
Lying around. No, not really. You've told me everything I need. This is like the little shopping district, and there's a little...
So you're that new gal from the Commonwealth.
Yeah,
so
that's me.
So wonderful to meet someone from back home. I'm afraid Kasumi doesn't seem to want to discuss it, but how are things there?
Is it getting better? Yeah, it's getting better.
Every day, I think.
Oh, that's so good to hear.
You
would like
have
to see
Ellie's outfit.
Someday, once things settle down here. Acadia is all well and good, I suppose. But honestly, it does get a bit boring.
Sarcasm.
If this is boring, I'd hate to see what you consider exciting.
Oh, aren't you a card? I'm sure I'll see you around. Do take care.
I like the synths. The synths have character. That's awesome. I like synths that have got character.
Right. Must be, because I don't recognize you.
That's
look, I'm not anybody worth talking to. My head is killing me. Now's not a good time.
Why not? Sarcasm?
Oh, yeah. Practically a 5-star resort you got here.
That was a bit harsh.
Yeah, sure. It's rough around the edges. But someday, it'll be amazing. You try having somebody botch a mind wipe on you and see how it feels. Then get back to me, okay?
Mind wipe? Sorry?
What do you mean, mind wipe?
Oh, for fuck's sake. You're a synth on the run. You go to someone, you get a new face, and they wipe your mind so the Institute can't find you. Only somebody screwed mine up. So here I am.
I'll take it back. I don't like the synths anymore.
Please. Leave me alone.
You're a little bit like you're bipolar.
You're here too, huh? I mean, I haven't been here that long myself.
Okay.
Honestly, I'd be dead right now if it weren't for Chase. Turns out it's pretty hard to live as a synth in the Commonwealth.
Pretty much getting that. It's, sorry you suffered, bro.
I'm sorry to hear that you suffered.
Thanks, but it doesn't matter now. I'm here, and I'm safe. And I'm never leaving.
What if I were to murder you? No, never mind. I'm not going to murder them. Deema, on the other hand, might murder Deema. Hello, you're working on an engine. You must be Kasumi.
Circuitry is completely fried.
Yes.
Kasumi Nakano?
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something.
Your parents sent me.
Your parents sent me. They want you to come home.
They did what? You came all this way for me.
Technically speaking, yes.
In fact, took a walk through the fog to find you.
Look, my mom and dad... I mean, those people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back. Not if they knew the truth.
Because you're a synth?
Because you're not really their daughter. You're a synth.
Yeah. Exactly. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them. How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead and I replaced her?
Yeah, but it wasn't really your fault. You didn't replace. You may have replaced, but you didn't know. You're not a replacement?
You haven't replaced anyone. Kenji and Ray are still your parents.
I really wish that was true. If I wasn't a synth, things would be so much simpler. Acadia isn't what I thought it was. There's more going on here than just the refuge.
Oh?
But I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I've been running long enough.
You're coming with me. Offer help. Nope.
If something's going on, then I can help.
I'm a detective.
Just tell me what's happening.
I don't know how you could. Wait. Wait, of course you can help. You find things, track down answers.
Yes, I detect.
That's what you do, right?
That's in the job description.
What if I told you that there's a secret? A big secret here on this island. Something way more important.
I would say, duh.
Sister, there's a lot of things on this island more important than you.
If you could just hold the jokes for a second. You
pretty fucking accurate, though. To, right?
They hold his memories or offload data from his brain. Or maybe some combination of both.
Uh-huh.
Well, Faraday asked me to help do some repairs on them. And, you know, I got curious. There's like a century's worth of life experiences in there. And that's when I see it. Data models Dima has been making. One was the fog taking over Far Harbor. Another was a nuclear detonation on the island. Plus, death counts. What if Dima is so open and welcoming because he's actually hiding something from us? A plan to wipe out the rest of the island.
Dima turning on Far Harbor? Now that would be cause for concern.
I love the fact that I'm just sitting there grinning. Ah, sarcasm.
Personally, I find calculated mass murder to be very soothing.
Look, help me out, and if I'm wrong, you can make all the jokes you want. Now, I've tried doing some digging on my own, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase head into the laboratory at the other end of the hall. Then they come out later looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop, but it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close, but the security on it is crazy.
I'll just talk to Dima.
This'll be easier if I just talk to Dima. Convince him that he needs to be honest with us.
All right. Good luck. Let me know what you
want. Well, that's gonna...
Whatever we find out, I hope there's a way to make some caps out of it.
Oh, you're a mercenary sort, so maybe I need to start asking for money.
Someone has the key to that storage room. Maybe Cog? He's always moving supplies around as they come in.
Okay, find Cog's bedroom, steal his keys, got it. Okay, Dima, let's have a natter. Let's see if we can do this together. Lights on. Hello.
Is there anything I can do?
Turn back Kasumi.
Kasumi says she's seeing parts of your memories. Death projections for Far Harbor and the center of the island.
Dun dun dun.
Unfortunate. She should be focusing on herself, her new life. She shouldn't have to bear the burden of the outside world. Please, this is a matter best left to me and my advisors. We aren't planning to destroy the island. Those projections were merely to help us realize the cost of inaction.
Okay, so...
Sounds like a lot of fancy talk aimed at throwing us off the trail.
I think he's probably telling the truth. I want to help.
If this thing involves the whole island, then you need help. I can be your problem solver if you let me in.
I suppose there's something to be said about refusing help, even when it's offered and you're in need. There's a conflict that's been brewing on this island shortly after we built Acadia. Between Far Harbor and the Children of Atom.
Okay, makes sense.
They want to kill each other, and each side wants us to help them.
We've tried to stay neutral, but Far Harbor was going to be wiped out by the fog. So that's when we built the condensers for them.
And I was friends with the previous leader of the Children of Adam, Confessor Martin. I even gave them their headquarters, the submarine base they named the Nucleus.
How did you own a submarine?
Because Martin is gone and the new confessor, Tectus,
good
is
name.
Completely insane.
He's been threatening us to force us to choose a side. I left behind something very important in
Why would you do a stupid thing like that?
Dima's earliest memories are stored in the military computer banks in that base. Pre-war security systems and Confessor Martin's goodwill were supposed to keep them safe.
But now Tectus is in charge, and he's after Dima's memories. We don't even know what's in them.
But we do know that I spent nearly a century on this island alone. Whatever's in there is too dangerous to allow Tectus to get his hands on them.
We assume. Okay, tell me about Far Harbor.
You're keeping Far Harbor safe, is that it?
Not exactly. They're fiercely independent. But the fog was starting to choke more and more of the island. So I proposed a trade.
Right.
We would give them the technology to keep the fog at bay, in return for them being a lifeline to the outside world. A safe dock, and a place to buy supplies. Unfortunately, the Children of Adam view the radioactive fog as a holy portent, and their bloodied history with Far Harbor puts us at odds.
Okay, Children of Adam?
The Children of Adam on this island. You were helping them?
Yes. I know their faith in radiation as a type of god is a bit different. But who am I to judge?
A sane, rational-thinking human being? Synth?
As a home
human being,
when
synth?
Martin and his followers stumbled inside. They had been cast out of Far Harbor for their beliefs. When I left to found Acadia, I knew the base would be in safe hands. They needed a home. A place to belong, just like I did.
Ah, things Martin never stay the gone, same.
And his successor, Tectus, wants to finally end the feud with Far Harbor by letting the fog swallow them.
Yeah, it's not going to happen. Okay, so I don't care about your memories. What can I do?
So what can I do to help?
If you're willing to retrieve what I've lost and bring my memories back to me, then we'd all be one step closer to solving this conflict without bloodshed.
Where's the fun in
You'll
that?
You have to get through the Children of Adam's base. You're new on the island. So you might be able to pose as a recruit.
Then, once you get to the memory banks, you'll have to use a special program Dima and I have been working on to break through the security systems.
It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder.
What, when I intrude on the memories, I'll be an intruder?
Instructions I've recorded.
Tricky, tricky,
that
tricky.
That will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
Well, sarcasm.
I'm going to replace all your memories with pictures of cats.
Meow.
Well, I suppose that would certainly make remembering some of my darker hours more fuzzy.
Yay.
In all seriousness, good luck. I understand the risks.
I like the fact that she emphasized cats with meow.
It's in all our best interest that you succeed. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, don't assault the Children of Adam directly. Our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
I've got no love for those mindless fanatics at the Nucleus. I won't complain if it comes to violence. Hell, I'm hoping it does.
Okay. I think I may have you pegged. You want to help Far Harbor?
Time keeping up with repairs before all this nonsense.
You're generally a good dude.
They're nothing you need to be concerned about.
It's not them. I'm concerned about you, Dima. You can't solve all the world's problems. Certainly not.
I feel like there's a love kind of triangle thing going on here, but without a third member. Hey, Kasumi!
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the Children of Adam. He's afraid of what they're going to find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? it wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the children of Adam will.
Something like that.
Is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind? Is there really something in them that's dangerous? Do you have a way in? Into his memories? Assuming you can get past the children of Adam, of course.
Yes, I've got a program.
I got this program that Faraday and Dima wrote. It's supposed to help me access the memory banks.
Really? How would that work? When I was taking a peek in the computers he has here, Dima was hooked up to his chair. I was just tapping into it. I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does. Some kind of connection between your head and the computer. Oh, but that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data, helping you through any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting, isn't it? You'll let me know what you find?
Nerd! Sarcasm.
All I find in those memories is just 100 years worth of Dima staring at a wall. I'm gonna be really annoyed.
Well, if you did, that's almost good, right? That means they're harmless. Anyway, good luck.
Okay, so we completed a questicle. Now, let's see what the next quest I'm going to choose is. Okay, I figured I'd start with the crazy lady. Let's go and eliminate some feral ghouls, because ghouls are, you know, piece of cake. And let's take a look at the map. It's just up the road, so I just need to follow this road down. Creepy, and no, let's turn off that. Do I want that gun, or... You know what, I can probably go with Hitman for this one, I think. It depends what we find there. Let's stick with Deliverer for now and see what happens. Interesting, you can sort of see the thick, you know, patches of where the radiation fog is. And you can sort of avoid them. So, yeah, no, it's actually much easier to handle than I was actually anticipating. See, that's a thick pack of fodge is what I'm trying to say for some reason. And I just avoid it and I come out relatively unharmed. And they put it across the road because it looks like they've got radiation beetles in it. And then you just stay out of it and you're fine. Like, yeah, there's a thick patch there. We're going to go right going around it and hopefully not die. Ooh, there's a ghouls in this here campground. Don't think I'm actually in the park just yet. I don't know. What's on the grill? Is there meat on the grill? There's no meat on the grill. Okay, but there is an outhouse out there. Ah, because it's out there. That's why it's an outhouse. Yeah, shut up. I'm smart, I'm clever, and I'm witty, goddammit. Not witty. Not particularly smart. Or particularly clever, actually. What? Okay, then. I guess I know what we're keep pulling out. Oh no. Legendary. Go. And just aroma. And oh, just a feral. Okay, let's just get the deliverer out because smarts. Beep 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 beep. Really? There we go. May not be fast, but I get there in the end. Okay. Where was that legendary? That's what I want to know. National Park Campground. There's a fog ghoul over there. Okay. And there's a roamer in that building there. Okay. Ghoul Slayer's metal left leg reduces damage from ghouls. There he is.
We ain't alone here.
Yeah, I know.
Well then, what's next?
Well, there's another one in there that's indicated that I have to go and deal with. But I'm hoping to do that quietly as well. God, I love this gun. I need to get the upgrades for it some point soon. Shoop. He needs the soup. Is there any more for anyone? Ah, I see you in there.
Time to earn that neck.
Time to earn that neck. I've got... Yeah. Okay. Oh, completed. Yeah, gonna go to Cassie Dalton, get myself some stuff. And you're not... Oh, don't shake, little man. It's fine. It's all good in the hood. Wow, I should never say that. Never say that. Oh, there's a... There's a handy.
Lost my home in the
first. Hello.
Ah, you there. Are you that detective I've heard about?
Something like that. Yes, I'm... You could say that.
I guess you could say that.
Oh, wonderful. I wasn't sure how I was ever going to find you. I haven't been able to find any of the local police force, the louts. I don't want to start a panic, but, well, we may have a murder on our hands and we need an outside set of eyes.
Who's we? Money.
Is this conversation on the clock?
I'm afraid that any further negotiations will have to be with my employers.
Damn it.
I'm sure they would be more than fair with you. Please, you must help us. Every moment we wait...
No, but he still liked the fact that I'm a mercenary bugger. Well, where's the crime?
Where did the crime take place?
At the Cliff's Edge Hotel, just north of the town. Will you help us? There may still be a murderer at large.
Who's the victim?
Who's the victim?
Well, we want to keep this out of the tabloids, but it's Ezra Parker, the financier of the hotel. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
Let's try this. Who are your employers?
Who are your employers?
I'm not at liberty to give out my employer's personal information, but you will, of course, be meeting with them if you take the case. Will you help us?
Yeah, sure. Okay, I'll help.
Okay, I'll help.
Oh, thank goodness. Shall I guide you to the Cliff's Edge Hotel now?
I've actually got that on my map. I will meet you there.
Go ahead. I'll meet you there.
Very good. I shall meet you at the main entrance to the hotel.
Okay, that makes... That makes sense. I want to have a look at...
Ready?
You and me need to talk.
I need to talk to you about a missing synth.
Yeah? Buy my guns. Well, it's not something I talk about with outsiders. So you can either buy something or move along.
Sarcasm.
Ah, that famous Bar Harbor hospitality. How could you not love it?
It grows on you. Will it be anything else?
Your designation.
I'm working with Chase. She told me that your designation is L792.
Okay, I believe you. But keep it down, all right? It's real private.
Is there something wrong with your...
I know the synth you're talking about. He's a younger...
With your eyes.
Maybe early 20s with white hair. Goes by the name Derek. Thing is, he showed up way earlier than he was supposed to. Thought a courser was on his tail, so he rushed the timetable. To be honest, the guy was a wreck. He was scared shitless. Looking over his shoulder every 5 minutes and attracting unwanted attention. Tried to calm him down, but he panicked and ran off into the fog. That was the last I saw of him.
Okay, time's running out, bro.
That synth could be wandering around out there right now, lost in the fog. I'm gonna need more than that.
And then ignore it for like months.
I know, all right? You think I wanted this to happen? Well, I didn't. Look. If you're really going after that synth, I'm pretty sure he took the road south out of town. Maybe you could head that way.
Okay.
Just be careful out there. And thanks. There aren't many who'd go out in the fog to help a synth, especially one they don't even know. I feel like
I've now
shit
canonized myself as a synth,
really,
so,
do.
You know.
I hope you can make it right.
Okay. We talked to Brooks.
Wouldn't it like that? Wonder you wiped out those crabs.
My little piddly gun. Yeah, if you, are
Brooks,
you open for bartering?
If you need any odds and ends, I'm your man.
Bait. Sure, bait that sounds deal. Interesting.
Apple.
Oh, it's just ammo. Okay. How the chufty chuff did I get 35 fusion cores? That's, interesting. I will sell my mini nukes, although they don't... Oh, but I got a crap ton of missiles. I will sell all of them. You may have my missile. Okay, that's fine. So I'm getting I'm actually starting to get money now.
Before the war, looks like.
Yeah, damn straight. Where was that lady? Okay, I think it's this guy.
Remember, the island's always watching. Be careful out there.
Yeah, yeah.
I wiped out the feral ghouls at the campground.
The hero of our saga returns triumphant. I bet the island didn't see that coming.
Well, no, because it's inanimate.
Only right you get paid for your troubles. Here's 200 caps for you.
Gee, more money.
I think I deserve more than that.
I suppose I could part with a little more.
Here's yeah, old love, long photos, mercenary
I've
bugger.
I've been thinking about what's next, and then it came to me. We all love our grandparents, don't we? Kind, gentle, doting, love to spoil.
I'm a synth, I don't have grandparents.
Something awful to happen.
I just have memories.
Nobody would. That's why it broke my heart when I lost Grandpa George.
Okay, you have my sympathies.
I'm sorry. You must have been very fond of him.
For everybody some reason was, that goes unsaid.
But that didn't matter to the island. Oh, no. He was cursed the moment he was born adult. He had a farm.
Yeah, what with people who die and everything. And it not being a natural part of life.
Not causing anyone trouble. The island sent something after him. A huge monster. Mean as spit and with claws to snap steel beams. A fog crawler.
Jeff, you snap steel beams.
He stood his ground. A shotgun in his hands. Holding off that terror while the farmhands fled back here.
That sounds like fun.
You can take out that shell-backed devil. It'll send a message loud and clear that says the Daltons never forget when they've been wronged.
Okay, that fog crawler will pay.
That fog crawler's gonna pay. For Grandpa George.
That's the spirit.
Jesus Christ. Eliminate the fog crawler. I don't even know what a fog crawler is. What's this? This is, retrieve the storage devices. Okay. No, that's not it. Where is it? Blood Tide. Eliminate the fog crawler. Map. Where are we going? Map. Map. Where's the fog crawler? Where's the, oh. Let's do it for Grandpa George! Far Harbor, explain, please. Are you actually... What are you doing? Are you just roasting this thing alive? Is this like boiled lobster? Does it have a rubber band around its claws?
The bait shop's got everything you need.
Well, there's a chopping board. And a table knife. Yes! This is exactly what this is. They are boiling a lobster in a lobster. Okay. Fine.
Don't let the island catch you off guard.
Okay, there's a restaurant down here. And something's in there. I'm just not sure what. It's ghouls. Okay. Can deal with ghouls. No? I'll get his head. It'll be fine. Boom! More ghouls. So we're in a restaurant. I can't see any more ghouls. I guess they're in here somewhere. Open the door. Oh, hidden. That was the one I just... He's got a dinner fork in the diner. Oh, hello. You're a reaver. Oh, look at your head. It go boom now. There you go. You're so pretty. One day, I would like to play as a ghoul. I just would.
Better us get it than someone else.
What, you mean the five caps there? Wow. Last of the big spenders. Hello. I am your friend. If your friends explode your head. You got a rat away. Can always do with a bit of rat away. In fact, I actually could. I'm running a little bit low. Fish! Today's fish is trout a la creme. Enjoy your meal. Don't know what that is, but it looks creepy as balls. You've got vim. There's no vim in my vim machine. No. No vim. No vim. I'm sorry. Rad rabbit. I'm critting that bastard. I want to see this thing. I've got a very Monty Python-esque thing in my head now. Red rabbit, run, run, run. If you, I'll eat you with my gun, gun, gun. Bang, 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 bang goes the farmer's gun. So rad rabbit, ow! What have we got in here? We have power armor. We have a T-51 regular. In some kind of paint job? Hang on. Craft.
Shooting up a truck full of good wine. I hope someone hanged for this.
Is that what vim is? Good wine? Okay. Power armor. Oh, I've remembered why I can't actually use power armor because of the strength. Okay. Craft. What have we got here? Vim refresh paint job. Let's. No. What's this? Quite. Okay. Exit. Okay. Take the fusion core. Because we're going to sell it. Oh, I can't actually. I need to wear this out of the truck. Okay. Right. Transfer that one back into it. I do give myself like 30 seconds of leeway in case something like this happens. So, yes, my stats must be the same except for the 30 seconds between, like, different things. So I can technically use these, but for only 30 seconds at a time.
Can't remember if I had my bath this week or not.
Yeah, you're a real charmer. Take that to sell it. Okay. Okay, so it's supposed to be around here somewhere. And I'm guessing in the water. Just wondering if I... Oh, it's a... I guess that's it. And the other one. Yeah, damn straight. That bugger moves fast. Where are you going, Grove? No. Do not submerge. I can chase you as long as I need.
We're just getting warmed up.
Yeah. 50-50 chance. Come on. Got it. Damn straight, I got it. Let's count the ammo and see what's left. I got enough ammo. I got like nearly 100. Why is that twitching? What the chuffy chuff is this? This is a regular foot crawler. Did it just murder another one? My one's... Oh no, this is the whale. This is the creepy dolphin whale. The dolphin shark teeth thing. You're tough, but you're not dangerously tough. Okay. Rule of threes in Fallout, so let's see what her third quest is going to be. Hey, lady, got some,
stands no chance against the crawlers.
I just killed
what
one.
Are you looking at?
You give that fog crawler what for? Courtesy of the Daltons.
Did.
Grandpa George can rest in peace.
Yeah, Grandpa George!
Dead.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic Avenger.
Yeah, heroic. I shot it with that from miles away.
Gone, we can send some folks up there to get the place ready for you. That's right. The farm is yours. Your own little piece of the island.
Oh, with all the dolphin corpses I could ever want.
But you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton lineage.
Could I have some more money, maybe?
Surely a heroic Avenger deserves more than 200 caps.
I can agree to that.
Yeah, level 39.
Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong as any a person can know.
Something
but
like
if
that.
You ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people.
Yep.
That's why the
should
last
be
part
at least
of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
Oh, I know how you feel.
Believe me. I know exactly how you feel.
If that's true, then I'm sorry to hear it. Perhaps we'll confront our pain together. My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget. I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse. No doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mole rats.
Aren't we all?
The leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You go and get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
Consider it done.
Trapper pay.
All right, then. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun.
For Grandpa George! Or for Danny. Or something. Okay. For this new level, I think I should go for Ninja. Ninja is pretty decent. Hello, kitty. Yeah, 3x3.5, so quite a bit of extra damage, considering that I could have probably taken out that four crawler in the first two hits, would probably have been useful. I'm going to go over to Righteous Authority to grind up crits on whatever it is that I come across next. Have we got a doctor? Heal me.
You another vulture circling over Andre's body? He ain't dead. Wait, no. It's a mainlander. Well, welcome to my little clinic. If you need doctoring, speak up. I wish I had time for some proper conversation, but my work's never done.
Could you stare at your patients all day? Who's Andre?
Who's Andre?
Poor Andre is my patient over there. He spent too long a spell in the fog. You may think you know your mainland radiation poison.
I do.
We got our own special brand here.
Lovely. Can I help?
I know a few things about medicine. Can I try to help him?
You say, what? You? Help? Well, poor Andre's got it bad. Good as dead.
That wasn't really a well-acted line.
I suppose there's no harm letting you have a poke. But I'll be watching you.
Guns, ammo, he says as he turns his back on me. Okay, hello, Andre. Ah, that good. Okay, leave him alone. Improvise a treatment. Use them. Hang on, leave him alone for a second. Didn't realise I was still carrying this around because I can't use it. Yeah, because it gets strength plus 5. Damage resist 50. Rads minus 36,000. Oh, yeah, actually, that makes a lot of sense, actually. Yeah, indeed. Mysterious serum. You inject the mysterious serum into Andre and his breathing rapidly stabilizes. He looks almost instantly better. Yes, and he also starts to rejuvenate as well.
Well, I'll be. I think you may have done it.
Oh, I have.
I'll keep looking after Andre. But I think thanks to you, he's got a fighting chance.
Yeah. Can
hey,
I talk?
Doc.
Welcome to my clinic.
Yeah, rad scrub me. You know what I love about my character? This is where I currently am. This is where she needs to be to kill trappers. I can swim. Like, really swim. What's this? Is this what's-his-face's cabin? Because if it is, it's a hole. Let's have a look out here. It's got rads on it, so yep, it's a hole. Welcome to Far Harbor. What you got? Oh, you get some decent stuff, I guess. I guess this isn't your home, otherwise you'd have said something. I'm guessing this is the MS Azalea, or as I like to call it, the Ms. Azalea. I'm not sure what's on there. There's got to be something on there. Trappers? Are there people? Oh, you're trappers. No, they're not. I'm going away. No, another place. I'm wondering what this place is. This place looks interesting. Can I flag a... Oh, they're a bad... That would be a super mutant. Dive, dive, dive. I'm not sure going towards the fire is much of a step up. Gonna be honest. This is probably a bad idea. Okay. You can stay here, Mr. Teddy Bear. Ooh, Huntress Island. That sounds ominous. That looks like a bottle factory, like the new Coca-Cola bottles. Guessing that would be the Vim? Vigor bottly things? I'm not sure what this is. This looks to be like a thing. What is this thing? Is this a thing? Hello, are you a thing? You appear to be a thing. Oh, there are ghoulies there. I'm not really interested in the ghoulies, the ghosties, or the long-leggedy beasties, to be honest. Is this where the trapper is? It looks like it. Can I... Hang on, hang on. There was an island back here. Let's go onto this island. Because somebody made like a crappy camping lodge here. Oh, hello. More stuff. Thank you. Pulse mine. Well, I don't use mines, but... Right, let's get my Snoopy Snooperson. No, that's a combat shotgun. Where is the hitman? The hitman's there. Okay. Right, I can see a stalking trapper. I'm guessing he's going to be at the top somewhere. Can I see someone mooching around the top? Because if I can, you know, that would be like fun if I could just take him out from here. Maybe if I can take that guy out, I can just sit on the edge of the docks and... You can't really find me because I'm sort of hidden in the darkness. The darkness is my ally. Where are you? Can't hit you with that. Oh. Silenced gun. I see you over there. Oh, I ran out of AP. Well, I'm going to reload whilst my AP comes back and see what I can do. Because I don't really want a grand firefight. To be honest, if I could just... Come on. I just want to murder him. Just want to... There we go. Sneak attack. Reload. I mean, he's got to be upstairs somewhere. And I really, really would like to be able to spy on him. But I've got these two guys down here. Yeah, you stand there. He's down. Okay. Oh, and you're just going to stand there, are you? Let's have a couple of shots at your head. Come on. Oh, you know I'm out here, do you? That's fine. Ah, perfect. Okay, gonna try sneaking onto the edge of the docks. There's a guy with some kind of launcher. I think it might be missiles, but it doesn't explode as much for missiles. But he was around here somewhere. And he went off that way. And I'm gonna crouch. And see what I can find as I sneak on by. Sneaking on by! Oh, old Longfellow, could you not? I am Stealthy McStealtherton. And seriously, bruv. Right, the guy is going to be up there. And trappers are serious business. Apparently. So. They're definitely fighting something else, though. Am I okay with that? Eliminate the trapper leap. Yes! I have eliminated the trapper leader! Apparently. Because I did not touch him. So, you know what? I'm going to consider that job done. Apparently, I killed him. I'm assuming somebody else killed him. That's fine. I was here. Therefore, fine. We'll come back and explore this fully, but seriously, I'm getting out of here. Okay, you crazy old bat. Give me your whatever reward for the third of the most important of your quests. Right, I guess.
You
Hello.
Take your time killing that trapper.
Yes, I did.
Make it hurt.
Oh, he suffered. He suffered so much.
Lost my Daniel.
Yes.
That trapper who killed your husband is dead.
Then yes, and done. I totally killed him.
It's finally done.
Totally.
All those lives
that was me.
That were lost. All those debts finally repaid.
Yes, and I repaid
and it
your
was
debts.
My son or daughter of Far Harbor who stood up to the island and avenged the Dalton bloodline. It was you, an outsider, a mainlander.
Because I am brilliant.
Been written. The story has come to an end. This is a day I never thought I'd live to see.
And I brought it to fruition. Me. Glad to help.
I was glad to help. I hope I've put your mind at ease.
You certainly have. Now every good story's gotta have a happy ending, right? The hero finds the treasure, saves the sweetheart, and rides off into the sunset. Well,
possibly.
I'm a little old to leap up on a horse. But I have got something close to a treasure. This is an heirloom that's been in my family for... for at least a generation or two. There's no Dalton left to inherit the thing. So it might as well pass on to you. The island knows this weapon. Oh, yes. You carry this, and it'll take you seriously. And that's it. That's the end.
I wish that were true. I wish there was something in the game's code that means things are more hostile.
No, and there won't be any unfinished
when you're carrying that gun.
Put me in the ground. Off you go now. My story's over, but yours... I think yours is only just getting interesting.
Bloodlet. Targets bleed for 25 points of additional damage. Okay, 56... And I have no melee skill. And it's got 25 bleed. If that's on each swing, that could be interesting. No, what am I talking about? I do not carry melee weapons. I have been Zombie Cleo. And we totally killed that trapper. Totally did it.
You are a curious specimen. Despite our friendly town doing its best to chase you out, you keep helping us ingrates all the same. I got to ask, why do you keep at it?
because you're good people. You're
good people in some dire straits.
And that was totally me. No one else killed that trapper.
You running for office? Well, if that's the truth, we don't deserve you.
Probably not.
You don't let them take advantage of you.
Most folk here are set in their ways, yes? It makes no difference how hard you try to get in good with them. Heck, it took my family 3 generations before the Daltons would sell us a heel of bread. But there's a way. A downright insane way, mind you. That you can turn even the most stubborn fool around.
Okay. Well, let's change opinions then.
I'd love to change their opinion of me.
Do it right. And all mainlanders might get treated better. In olden
what
times,
is with your hand? You're doing that point that politicians do with 2 fingers.
Legends say the toughest, meanest, and outright craziest hopefuls would chum the waters and lure out the worst the island could throw at them. Once the would-be captain killed the Mirelurk Queen, or Fog Crawler, or what have you, they'd invite the whole island to feast off the bounty. You do this, well, you won't be made captain, but you'll earn respect. Everyone's respect.
Okay, I am ready to be
a
legend.
Become a legend, then.
You what? You crack me up. There's an old Mirelurk feasting grounds by Emmett's Causeway, a treacherous stretch along the coast. Go there and throw any kind of meat you got into the water. All that blood and viscera will be sure to attract attention. And then wait. I'll make sure there's a witness or two. Prove to the rest of these clods you belong.
Okay, that was weird.
The children of Adam are dangerous. Don't trust them.
Well, says the people that live in a fog. Anyway, I've been Zombie Cleo. This has been the Jack of All Trades Challenge. Class dismissed.